بسم الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. كل عام وأنتم بخير. ما شاء الله. May Allah facilitate every good in this world and the next for everyone who is present and those who are absent. Say Ameen. Alhamdulillah, we ask all the believers, inshallah, to please come forward. Please come forward, inshallah. The Prophet said the hadith, أَزَاهُمُ تُرَاحَبُ. Find yourself in the crowded space and you will find the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَزَاهُمُ تُرَاحَبُ. Please come forward, inshallah. Please move the ranks forward, inshallah. From the back, we are getting signs of you. Can please move forward, inshallah. So inshallah, the Eid, as it comes twice a year, a brief explanation for those that are new and anyone else that is needing a reminder, such as myself. So it is different than the Jumu'ah in that we have the Salat first, two Raka'at similarly. The Imam will read seven Takbirat in the first Raka'at and six in the second Raka'at. After the finishing of the Salat, inshaAllah, then I will give the Khutbah similar as we give it with the addition of the Takbirat. Seven Takbirat in the first Khutbah, a sitting by the Imam, and then a standing, and then six following up in the second Khutbah. Please feel free to express your joy, your love, your happiness through your takbirats of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, exalting Him through this way in which He has asked us to exalt Him. This is a beautiful and joyous occasion, alhamdulillah. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for facilitating it for us. Ameen. The seven takbirats are in addition to the takbir that we make to enter into the salat. So we'll say Allahu Akbar, but it's seven in addition to that. And the same thing when we come up from the qiyam, from the second raka'at, it's the takbir of Allahu Akbar, and then six subsequently following that.
Please make the line straight. Istaqimu wa'tadilu. أثابني وأثابكم الله. بسم الله. الله أكبر.
الله
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى
شاء فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا سمع الله لمن حمده
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله الله أكبر سلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله أكبر 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 إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله خير نبي اجتباه وهدى للعالمين أرسله أرسله الله بدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأزواجه وذريته وأصحابه والتابعين والتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد عباد الله أذكركم إياي بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى أذكركم بقوله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم حيث يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أذكركم إياي بالحفظ القرآن الكريم والسنة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، ولله الحمد. Allahu Akbar for the number of people who have ever fasted the month of Ramadan. Allahu Akbar for the amount of mercy poured out upon us in the month of Ramadan. Allahu Akbar the number of letters that we read in the Quran. Allahu Akbar the number of tears shed seeking Allah's forgiveness in the month of Ramadan. Allahu Akbar for the number of people who prayed Taraweeh, who fed loved ones, guests, and friends. Allahu Akbar for the number of people who fell in love with the Creator in this month of Ramadan. Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah wa lillahi alhamd. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly for the numerous opportunities He provided us to worship Him and demonstrate our obedience to Him, His commands and His mercy for us and generosity that He pours out on us. We praise Allah. We praise Him for the degree of pardon that we receive in this month. And we bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His prophet and messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that He conveyed the message, completed His mission, and advised the ummah, and left for us an undoubted truth. Whomsoever strays from this truth has left clear guidance. Allah gives us many opportunities in this life to pause and examine our lives, our actions, and our relationship with Him. Just like a person traveling who stops to check his vehicle, his time, and his direction, such a person uses landmarks on the road as indicators to ensure they are traveling in the right direction. Similarly, our spiritual life. We have the five times when we stop each day and pause from our busy schedules to perform a quick check. We have the weekly opportunity of the Friday prayer to perform another check and evaluate. And we have the month of Ramadan that allows us an entire month to examine our system and recharge our spiritual batteries. All of these are opportunities to cleanse our souls and renew our commitment to Allah in preparation for our meeting Him. Allah also gives us the two Eids, two fresh starts to provide us with the enthusiasm and hope. Our sitting here today represents our connection to Allah. Our sitting here today represents our connection to Allah. And we should never leave here. We should not leave here today except for with a complete conviction, a complete belief that every day represents an opportunity for us to draw nearer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu Akbar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in the hadith that every known day tells us, O children of Adam, Ya Bani Adam, Ya Bani Adam, I am a new day and will testify about you on Yawm al-Qiyamah. So make the best of me. So make the best of me. Allah has brought us here to make us the best of ourselves on this day. Allahu Akbar. Regardless of anything else that people want to tell you or that you may be feeling, you must know in your hearts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought you here for you to make the best of this day. Not just any day, but this special day. Today is the day we celebrate Allah's mercy and forgiveness, Allahu Akbar. Eid is this opportunity for us to reevaluate our course and reorient ourselves. But the beauty of Eid is not limited to this day. The beauty of Eid is not limited to this day. A wise man once said, today is Eid, tomorrow is Eid, and every day that passes without disobeying Allah is Eid. What does that mean? It means that the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that should be sought constantly, and it should be a constant cause of celebration in our lives. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us in this hadith Qudsi, O son of Adam, so long as you call upon me and ask of me, I shall forgive you of what you have done. Wa la ubali, and I shall not mind. It is of no concern to me. O son of Adam, were your sins to reach the clouds of the sky, were you then to ask forgiveness of me, I would forgive you. Allahu Akbar. I would forgive you. This is your Lord, the creator of the heavens and earth, and every animate, inanimate object, from the time of kun fa kun until the trumpet is blown, saying that I forgive you. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. O son of Adam, were you to come with me with sins nearly as great as the earth, and were you to face me, ascribing no proverb to me, I will bring you forgiveness nearly as great as it. Ramadan is this month of forgiveness. Allah has dedicated this month to forgive us. Allah has dedicated this month 29 or 30 days for our forgiveness, for us to bring taqwa into our lives so that we may draw closer to Him, so that our families may draw closer to Him, because it is all a preparation for our meeting with Him. This is why we celebrate, and this is why we cry out, Allahu Akbar. This Eid represents opportunities to start anew with a recommitment to sincerity and expression of love for the one who pours out his love on us. It is this recommitment to obedience that propels us into the coming days, that will allow us to have complete conviction and trust in our Lord. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله خير نبي اجتباه إلى العالمين أرسله. أرسله الله بدين الحق ليظهر عليه كله ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الأولين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في الملأ على إلى يوم الدين. وعلى آله وأزواجه وذريته وأصحابه والتابعين والتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد عباد الله، أذكركم بآية بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى، وذكره من قوله سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم حيث قلت في الحديث: اتقوا الله حيثما كنتم. Fear Allah wherever you are. أذكركم بشرف مكان المصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم حيث يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك أنت حميد مجيد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. ولله الحمد. Brothers and sisters in Iman, when we reflect on the history, we realize that all are going through a process of constant change. This is the course destined for us by Allah, and nothing can change that. Tell me, if an honorable guest visits us, showers us with all forms of goodness and love, and we reciprocate, and when the time for that departure of that guest arrives, how are we going to bid farewell, and how are we going to fear? What separation that is greater and more emotional than that of our beloved guest, the blessed month of Ramadan? Ramadan is the month of mercy, forgiveness, righteousness, generosity, the month of liberation from Allah's anger. Yesterday we were congratulating each other on the arrival of the month. Today we are consoling each other for its departure and begging Allah to accept our acts of worship. In this noble month, many of us have done good deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of them. Ameen. Our actions are going to testify for us on the Day of Judgment. We do not know whether we are going to live to witness another blessed month of Ramadan. So therefore, the fortunate Muslim during this month was the one who was able to improve their acts of worship with sincerity and self-examination and end it with sincere repentance. May Allah accept.
Amen.
For actions are judged by their ends. Actions are judged by their ends. Truly the wise amongst us exerts maximum effort in perfecting their acts of worship and whose concerns is regarding the acceptance or rejections of the actions. Ali ibn Talib radiallahu anhu, karamallahu wajhu, said, have a greater concern for the acceptance of your deeds than you have for the amount of deeds that you have performed. Our life is a journey of change. Nothing we experience in this life is permanent. Rather, every situation is temporary and simply transforms into another. These constant experiences are reminders of the temporary nature of this life. That everything in this dunya, by its very nature, is meant to change. Every ease and hardship that we face does not last forever. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامِ يَدَاوُونَهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. And that these days of varying conditions, we alternate them amongst people. So alhamdulillah, to have fasted this month of Ramadan is to experience those varying conditions mentioned in the verse. And this experience of change is then realized in each of our experiences that bring these varying conditions into our lives. We have just completed a time in our lives of grace and spiritual energy when our acts of worship practiced throughout the year take on a whole new meaning, pursued with a greater sense of urgency. Laylatul Qadr, as the Prophet ﷺ said, is a time for us to exert ourselves seeking a spiritual breakthrough. It is similar to the entire month of Ramadan, and we'll become proactive in it, creating these conditions. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes this month and that night a means of transformation in all of our lives. Ramadan created a time for us when we were able to place a barrier between ourselves and our desires in this world. The importance of this is that by not constantly absorbing sustenance from our surroundings, we are forced to realize that we have less dependence upon our food and drink. This is a mercy from Allah, and this should make us realize the amount of thanks and forgiveness that we show through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through our constant provisions. We also realize that we should use this to devote ourselves more fully to the one who provides this source than the sustenance itself. Ramadan undoubtedly becomes a time when our spiritual lives take on whole new meanings, the Quran yields new meanings, new secrets and new treasures for all, and we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His continued blessings beyond the month of Ramadan. As believers, this month teaches us that we should be like a firm tree. We should hold firm and send our roots deep into the soil so that we can stand tall. We must constantly seek to water our hearts with what is pure in order to strengthen our roots and our soul. And we must finally aim to be of constant benefit to our environment and those around us. If we aim to instill these qualities within ourselves, the constant changes we experience in our lives cease to become a distress and hardship, rather they will become a source of strength that brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In closing, Ramadan purifies our souls and whole communities of misdeeds and misunderstandings of the previous year. And it is the powerful energy of the source from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that allows us to experience reform and become new people. So that when the month is over, the festival begins, and the believer can face the future with new determination and strength, repentant from our former bad habits, committed to never return to them. This way, all of us, and by extension our communities, purify itself during this blessed month, which becomes the turning point of the year, and for many of us, is the turning point of our lives. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept us in this month. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us life to see another month of Ramadan. Allahumma arhamna al-mu'mineen wal-mu'minat, al-muslimin wal-muslimat, al-ahya'a minhum wal-amwat, ya arhamar rahimin. اللهم إننا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى عن الناس يا رب العالمين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا إننا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لكننا من الخاسرين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذريتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا، اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا، اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا يا رب العالمين، وتقبل منا صلاتنا يا رب العالمين، وتقبل منا قيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا يا رب العالمين، وتقبل منا تلاوة القرآن يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل القرآن ربيع قلوبنا وشفاء صدورنا يا رب العالمين، ونور في قبورنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن. اللهم نسألك علا من الجنة، اللهم نسألك علا من الجنة، اللهم نسألك علا من الجنة. O Allah, most gracious, most merciful, we turn to you in prayer to express our thanks on this blessed day of Eid that you have bestowed upon us the blessing of this great day. O Allah, we call on you, the creator of all mankind. Free us from our ego, greed, lust, and hatred. Replace it with humility, contentment, compassion, and love. We humbly place ourselves at your mercy. Forgive us for our sins and protect us from all forms of evil. O Allah, bless our parents for placing a kalima on our tongues and helping us to express it in our deeds. O Allah, free us from the chains of evil powers. Relieve the loneliness, the pain and suffering of our aged ones, our brothers and sisters who are ill. Fulfill the needs of those who have no voice except for your grace, Ya Allah. Allow us to turn to you at all times, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, for anyone who is facing a difficulty, we ask you to remove that difficulty from that ameen. We pray for the souls who have departed this world. Grant us the strength and faith to tread the months ahead with a revitalized patience and sacrifice. May the blessings of this great day abide with us and serve as a source of comfort during the moments of suffering and despair throughout the year. We have answered your call to draw closer to you. We beseech you, O Allah, answer the call we made to thee in this blessed morning. Allahumma ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa kul'am wa antum bi khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.